Over here.
It's Sarah from the Good Hunter.
Oh, finally, I caught you. I have something I'd like the Knights of Favonius to do for me, and I want you to pass on my request to the Acting Grand Master.
Oh, so it's Jean you were really hoping to see.
You are close with her. Really? It must be a good feeling knowing Jean's got your back.
Anyway, what was it you wanted us to tell Jean?
Oh yes, I must apologize for being unable to visit the Knights in person, but the restaurant has been so busy lately. Unfortunately, it's right in this busy season that the route between here and Springvale, which is used for the delivery of our ingredients, seems to have been occupied by the Hillichurls. The problem is that the suppliers in Springvale say that deliveries have nothing to do with them. They're just responsible for selling us the ingredients. That would be great. Please, ask Master Jean to send a party to clear out the Hillichurls from the road to Springvale. Help at last. With Jean on the case, this will be solved in no time. Thank you.
Seems like everyone really trusts Jean.
Oh, I nearly forgot. Charles the bartender said he's been having some trouble too. Why don't you stop by and see him on the way?
Fine. In for a penny, in for a pound is the Paimon way. But this is really stretching the definition of on the way, in my opinion.
What do you think this is, kiddo? A fruit juice store?
How rude! Especially since we're here to help!
Help? Oh, yes! You're the acting grandmaster's new hotshot helper, aren't you?
That's one way of putting it, but...
Great! Tell Jean I need my quarterly tax return forms, then. It's time to get Elzeron to doing the accounts again. I must say, though, the tax rate on alcohol and acting Grandmaster Jean personally goes over all the accounts. After all, the wine industry is Mondstadt's main source of income. Jean takes great pains to make sure no detail is overlooked.
Paimon never knew that. Jean's job is even harder than it seems.
The acting Grandmaster's hard work indeed makes our lives a whole lot easier. We're certainly very lucky, but to put it bluntly, we just take it for granted that that's the norm now.
Wow! How do you sleep at night knowing how much pressure you put Jean under?
When you put it like that, I do feel quite ashamed. I suppose I should give her one on the house next time she's here. Although, I doubt the acting Grand Master even has the time to spare for that.
Sounds like a poor excuse to deny Jean a free drink. Come on! Let's go and see Jean.
You've got to try Dawn Winery's Dandelion Wine.
Go ahead and pick up some new pieces from Shokes' blacksmith.
Hey, you two!
Margaret? What are you doing here?
My cat's gone missing. Have you seen it? This is a bit worrying. What if Prince can't find...
But we are on our way to an urgent meeting.
You're on the way to see Jean?
Paimon thought you were looking for a cat.
Yes, I wanted to see if Jean could help look for my cat.
Seriously? You want Jean to help look for you?
What's wrong with that? Jean's a really nice person. Please mention it to Jean for me. I'll treat you to a brew at Cat's Tail later.
Hey! Hey! Ugh, unbelievable! Guess the case of Prince the Missing Cat is now added to the agenda for our meeting with Jean! Acting Grand...
Oh, it's our honorary knight. Sorry, I must have been daydreaming. How can I assist?
Actually, it's not us who need your help. It's a bunch of other people.
I see. Well... Thank you for your service to the people of Mondstadt. I have made a note of these commissions in my files, and I will make arrangements accordingly.
Great! We didn't miss out on anyone's commissions, did we? Sarah's Hilly Churls, Charles' tax return, Margaret's cat. We'll be on our way then, Jean. Jean, are you okay? Jean holding up. Is it serious?
It's just burnout from work stress. She'll be fine after a good old rest. Thanks for bringing her here. She may have tried to keep soldiering on otherwise.
It's not a surprise, though. She does have a lot to get through every day.
Poor Jean. She's always been one to push herself too hard while overlooking her own needs. This isn't the first time something like this has happened. Anyway, you're an honorary knight, aren't you? While the master is down, the knights should share her burden, no?
That's a very good point, but shouldn't one of the fully qualified knights do that?
Jean has so much to do. An extra pair of hands can't hurt. You should go and check in at the headquarters. Jean will be fine with just me here.
Paimon feels like she's trying to get rid of us.
Why is that?
Nothing. We'll leave you to it! Come on, let's go!
Let the wind...
is making me sleepy.
Anything the knights can do for you. Anything the knights can do for you?
When Barbara's working, she's so...
Anything the knights can do for you? Anything the knights can do for you?
Oh, it's Kaya!
I've been waiting for you. I have been informed about Jean falling ill. On behalf of all of the Knights of Favonius, allow me to express my sincere gratitude for your assistance.
So courteous and polite. This isn't the Kaya Paimon knows.
Well, the circumstances warrant it. This is the acting Grand Master herself we're talking about. Now, in addition to that thank you message, there was one other thing. It's like you read my mind. We have quite a connection, don't you think?
Things like helping to fill in for Jean?
Right. Although the commissions you reported to Jean have already been handed off to someone else, I am concerned that they will not be handled with due care without Jean's personal touch. So I am hoping that you can help out where you see fit. I will feel much more at ease knowing that the honorary knight is personally overseeing these cases.
You can flatter us all you want, but answer me this. Why don't you do it?
Oh, I have far more important matters to attend to. There are so many things to prepare.
Fine, then. So it's Sarah, Charles, and Margaret's stuff you want us to help with, right?
Those are the ones. I appreciate the help. See you.
Yours is the cat that went missing.
Venti! Have you come to help?
Me here to help you? Why, on the contrary, it is I who needs the helping.
But Paimon just saw you talking to Margaret about Prince!
So, Prince is the name of the feline fiend who thieved my spare astral iron strings. Though it gladdens my heart to see that the free-spirited ethos of Mondstadt is alive and well in creatures great and small, still, it's a bit audacious.
Prince is a mischievous little rascal, all right.
Indeed. Just like Barbados.
Yes, quite. Quite. Now, let's see about getting ourselves an audience with His Little Highness, Prince Rascal of Mondstadt. I have a performance tonight, and without my spare strings, I shall have to disappoint my audience.
What would a kitty cat want with lyre strings anyway?
Everyone knows cats go crazy for a ball of string.
What?
These lyre strings are made of astral iron, which contains animo energy. That makes them extreme. That's a trick of the
The strings contain anima. That'll help us. It's time for you to. I'm unsure there must be some.
Thank you all. Take this fish. It's little prince's fish.
really familiar. Haven't we seen it in the Cat's Tale before? Yep, that's Prince, all right! Wow, Prince has very keen senses. It didn't take much to scare him off. See if you can approach him quickly. It must be difficult not being able to. If you're anxious to find Prince, if you run out of fish... His senses are keener than we thought. He can't have gone far, though. Why not track him with your elemental sight? Next time, try creeping up from behind. Quietly, of course. Or, if you're feeling patient, use some fish as bait and catch him off guard.
Where did you go running off to? Oh, thank goodness.
We definitely had our work cut out for us. Look.
Oh, Princey. How could you leave me like that?
Looks like those two need some time to themselves. And here are your astral.
You found them! Wonderful. I dare say that a private. Apologies. At this distance, my cat allergy seems to be rearing its head.
Oh, now Paimon gets why you didn't go looking for your strings by yourself.
Anyway, thanks for the help. I'll be going now.
Lisa, are you here about the tax return?
Oh, hello, darling. You're quite right. After I heard about poor Jean, I thought I might lend a hand with some of her more literary duties.
Cool!
Wait a moment. Actually, Charles here was wondering...
Please, allow me. I just took a rather important... If it's not...
What's so urgent about...
It came in at the last minute.
Exactly. Hence the urgency.
Come take a look.
is where Charlie.
Have you come to rescue me? I've been. And all the time I've been working at. If you'd taken any longer.
Fear not! My.
Just as well. Then. And be careful with it. I'll be waiting up ahead.
Show them. A sight to behold.
Fate is upon you.
Emerge.
Cool it. Oh, so sorry.
Written in the stars.
Come on out. I'm always watching.
Thank you, my friend. I thought I was in deep trouble this time. It's a good thing you showed up. I'll put in a good word for you with the gentleman at the winery.
Let's finish this swiftly.
Thank you.
Another Paimon? Victory is almost ours! Wow, Paimon's stomach is rumbling already! signs of Treasure Order activity here. They must have come to these ruins. Let's go deeper inside. Paimon sure hopes... There aren't many guards here. But the plan to draw away the Abyss Order's forces really worked.
Let me scry. Show them. Right now. Right here. Emerge. Shadows of fate. Come on out.
Treasure Order was here. This should be the right direction. But why does it feel stranger and stranger as we make it deeper into these ruins? Be careful now. Paimon's right behind you. like a person. Could it be the Grand Thief? Why is he in that position? Is he praying to something? That's... Why is the Statue of the Seven hanging upside down? And the statue's hands... Paimon remembers they're normally holding an orb, right? But this statue is holding... What is that? Paimon has... And the Grand Thief hasn't moved an inch. Do... Hello? Paimon doesn't feel so good.
You have come here. You have seen our secrets. For this, you must pay the price. As a herald, I will mete out your punishment.
An Abyss Herald?
Dane. Dainsleith. Oh, I thought you were just a couple of pests that stumbled in here by mistake. So, you are with Dainsleith, that constant annoyance in our affairs. Did he send you here to die? His resistance against the Abyss has gone nowhere for a long time. There is nothing you can do to change the tide. The Abyss is unstoppable.
What is this power?
Into destiny. Ha! Decided by destiny.
Right now. Emerge. Right now. Right here. Here, emerge.
This power, it seems familiar. I see. So it's you. You are the one. In that case, I shall stay here no longer.
What a tough battle! Are you okay? Oh, such a strong enemy! Who knew the Abyss Order had monsters this powerful? Huh? What is it? What do you think? Oh, right, yeah! We're near the exit now. Let's get out of this scary place before something even more dangerous shows up.
So, we meet again. A little sooner than I had expected.
Hey, it's Dane!
Judging by your expression, it seems you just experienced something quite strange. Could it be that you encountered an Abyss Herald in those ruins?
Huh? How did you know that?
I've been on the Abyss Herald's trail. I didn't expect to find you here as well. An inverted statue of the Seven, holding abyssal power in its hands. No, I have never seen such a thing during my time fighting the Abyss, though I have had my suspicions. Tell me the rest of what happened in there. So you escaped the ruin depths filled with abyssal power, and then?
And then, as we got close to the exit, an Abyss Herald suddenly appeared and blocked our way! We fought a big battle with that thing. Maybe it hasn't gotten too far yet.
Yes, this is a rare opportunity indeed.
Let's go! A rare opportunity? With Dane helping out, maybe we'll be able to solve more mysteries about the Abyss!
Hmm.
Guess we can rest a bit.
Right now.
Those abyss mages just now, were they trying to ambush us?
No. They were just digging through these abandoned ruin guards looking for something of value.
Oh, is that so? The traveler here seems to like doing that a lot too. Looking for chaos devices, chaos circuits, you know, that kind of...
They wouldn't be searching for such ordinary objects. In fact, I was nearby investigating precisely because abyss mages often come out from that ruin to explore. They seem to be searching the remains of ruin guards for a certain valuable object to take back to the ruins. However, they look disappointed, so it would seem they haven't found it yet.
Why didn't you grab one of them just now and ask what they were up to?
I certainly don't mean to be merciful towards these monsters of the abyss, but I have a feeling that their plan with this object is of major importance to the entire Abyss Order.